on the road is a win. Any way you can get it, as pretty as it can be, you take what you can get, right?
Yeah, it is. And I'm excited for the win. I'm excited to get out of here and not have too many injuries because we had a tough 2 weeks. Tough travel to this place. I thought they had a great game plan, and our guys responded. So excited about the win.
Let's begin with your defense, and we discussed it going in. Hard to get home as a defense to counter Sampson because of how quickly he throws the football. But you had a lot of pressures. You had four sacks and limited him to 207 yards. And while Dennis Houston had 14 catches, the leading gainer of receiving yards in the country only had 71. Your defense took their top two weapons and really limited what they could do.
Yeah, our guys did a good job of number one, knowing where number 10 was, and they understood to not get frustrated because their quarterback gets it out quick. We played well, and I think sometimes you get discouraged because you have so many plays and all this and that, but in the end, you win the football game, and that's what matters.
How good is Reese Winkleman playing right now?
He's playing really well. He's healthy. He's a leader, one of the leaders of the D-line. He's very confident. He's a treat to be around.
Two sacks, fumble forced, fumble recovered today as well. And offensively, you did have the one turnover, which was kind of on a freak play as well. But in the first half, struggled to really find rhythm. But in that second half, man, you got it going offensively.
Yeah, the big play in the game, I thought, was the punt block. It was kind of dead around here, our team included. And I thought that energized us. But our offense responded in the second half. They give us a lot of stuff, a lot of blitzes. You saw that. And our blocking rules were sometimes messed up. They'd have an unblocked guy. But bottom line, we won, and we walk out of here and feel good about that.
I want to revisit what you talked about. You're up 13-10, start of the third quarter, force a three and out, and then what began just a tremendous amount of punting issues for Western Illinois. You had about four guys that in theory could have gotten home on that punt. Kinzer Madison does. He blocks it. Bauer picks it up. And like you said, the energy on that sideline was increased dramatically.
Yeah, that was a super play. And, just the quick turnaround, you know, the defense got to go back out. They were excited to go back out because of three and out and the block punt. You never know in football when you're going to change the momentum or when you're going to make the play that wins it. And Kinzer was ready. And Amar had a chance later on, and I don't know about the angle he took, but maybe could have got one also.
Two defensive players who saw their snaps increase this week and rose to the occasion. I thought Peyton Schaefer and Cale Reeder both played very well today.
Yeah, I thought they did too. I thought Peyton, he played a lot of reps again because they had a lot of reps, and he had the one interference call or holding call, but he played well, made some good tackles in the open field. And Cale is a really good football player, and we gave him more reps today, and he responded and made some plays.
And Canyon Bauer has a career-long catch of 36 yards. Nearly had a touchdown catch, too. It was a heck of a play by them to stop it. And then, of course, he plays a role in the punt block and scores a touchdown today also.
Yeah, he had a catch on the sidelines also. Canyon's a good football player. It just so happens we have the Yankees, and they're pretty good football players, too. But I loved that in the 2 minutes. He caught it with confidence, turned upfield, didn't take an easy way out, and it got us in position to maybe get a touchdown. We ended up with a field goal.
Thing you were proudest of today was?
I think the way we handled everything. You know, this is such a unique travel deal, and then you walk. It's a five-minute walk to the field. There's nothing wrong with that, but it's so different. We have a bunch of guys that have never been here, and I thought we started out the game and played really well at times. Not necessarily offensively, but again, they gave us a bunch of stuff. And so just our maturity, I guess, I'd sum it down to that.
You've talked a lot about wanting your tackling to be better. How'd you feel you tackled today?
I thought we tackled better. Yeah, I didn't see many broke tackles that got away from us. I think the running back had one on the sidelines. We tackled guys in the open field. We dove one time on the reverse, and the guy jumped over us. But that's not tackling. That's just missing, you know. Grab some cloth. But, yeah, I thought it was better. How many plays did they have, Tyler?
In the end, they ran 69.
Okay, and I think they'd been in the 80s, so that's a real great job by our offense maintaining the ball and our guys getting off the field, so that's super.
One final note about today, Cole Fromm with two field goals. He's now had 24 for his career. That ranks seventh in school history.
He's a good kicker. He's a really good kicker. And Fromm's a good kicker. I love his confidence. Great job on kickoffs. He's gonna be a difference maker down the stretch.
Before we lose all power, tell me about being home next Saturday, Northern Iowa, Hobo Day.
I can't wait. I can't wait for people to come home to South Dakota State, for the energy, for the students to be there, for the traditions, and to play at home. It's always sweet. And I think we're averaging maybe under 14,000. Love to have 18,000. I guarantee it's going to be a great day.